In 2008, the mismanagement of money by the major banks triggered a global financial crisis, causing many ordinary people to lose their homes. Trust in the system plummeted. But in the midst of all the chaos, on October 31st, 2008, something remarkable happened. A mysterious person or group using the name Satoshi Nakamoto introduced an idea online. It was for something called Bitcoin. It was published in the form of a white paper and posted on an internet forum titled Bitcoin, a peer-to-peer electronic cash system. The paper outlined an entirely new internet-based financial system that would allow users to securely transfer currency without the need for third parties such as banks. Now, little is known about the mysterious Satoshi. In 9 short pages, he, she, or they proposed a digital system that would completely revolutionize how we use money, all built with computer code. A decentralized, peer-to-peer digital payment network. In January 2009, the Bitcoin network officially went live. And just to ensure no one had any doubt as to why this new value system was created, Satoshi included a news article in the very first block of Bitcoin data. The article was from that month's Times newspaper in London. The headline read, "Chancellor on the brink of second bailout for banks." Now, Bitcoin isn't a network run by one person, a company, or even a single country. Instead, it's powered by thousands of computers spread all over the world. These computers are so-called nodes. Every time someone sends Bitcoin, this network of computers works together to verify the transaction. They make sure the person sending the Bitcoin actually has it and hasn't tried to spend it twice. This process is called consensus. And because the network is decentralized, there's no central point of failure. Even if some computers go offline or someone tries to attack the system, the rest of the network keeps running. It's like a giant web that's always connected. But how is Bitcoin made and circulated? Well, unlike fiat or normal money, which governments can just print more of, and they do, there will only ever be 21 million Bitcoin. That's it. No one can just make more Bitcoin. The way Bitcoin is made and distributed all falls down to miners. Miners are computers that compete to solve complex puzzles. The first one to solve the puzzle gets to add a new block of transactions to the blockchain. As a reward for their work, the miners earn newly created Bitcoin. This is called the block reward. It's like a digital race where the winner gets paid in Bitcoin, which in many cases gets sold and circulated, while their work helps to keep the network running secure and smoothly. Oh yes, and every 4 years since its inception, there's been a Bitcoin halving. The rewards miners get halves, which means the amount of Bitcoin going into circulation halves too, which is historically driven the price of Bitcoin up, increased demand, and reduced supply. So why does all of this matter? Well, Bitcoin offers something revolutionary. It's money that doesn't rely on banks or governments. It's decentralized, meaning no one controls it, and it's open to anyone with an internet connection. Since its launch in 2009, Bitcoin has become more than just money. For some, it's a way to invest or store value. For others, it's a way to send money across borders or offset currency devaluation. So that, my friends, is Bitcoin in under 5 minutes. Check out our other videos as we lift the hood on crypto.